Felicia got out of jail. When she got home, I had got a call from her screaming on the phone, "What did you do? What did you do?" I said, "What do you mean? What did I do? I did exactly what we agreed upon to raise $2,500 to get you out of jail. I did just that, and it's because of my honesty and my loyalty that you're out of jail. So why are you calling me screaming, 'What did you do? What did you do?'" She goes, "But my entire bedroom set is gone. The couch you said you was gonna leave here is gone. My entire dining room set is gone. You was only supposed to sell the bed and the living room TV." I said, "Hold up now. You know all those items, they were used items. So when the people came, they weren't trying to pay the original money you spent on those household materials. So I had to drop the price and throw in the extra stuff so that the people can buy it and we can come up with the $2,500. And that's why you're out of jail. So you got no business calling me and screaming, 'What did you do? What did you do?'" And she's like, "You know what? I'm taking you to court because I only asked you to sell the bed in the living room TV." I said, "No, the point was to raise $2,500. I did what I had to do and I raised that $2,500. And before you think you're taking me to court, I want to let you know that I recorded the conversation between us. The goal was to achieve $2,500. I did just that. I did what I had to do to raise the $2,500 for you, you ungrateful twit." Listen. Okay, anyways, Felicia, listen, stop tripping. If you need something to borrow to sleep on for the time being, I have my yoga mat and a few baby blankets here you can borrow. She's like, "You know what? To hell with you. Go to hell." I say, "I'm right after you." 5 minutes later, the beheaded Benedict calls me talking about, "So you acting like you wanted me to support her, you wanted me to look out for her, but you went and sold this girl's stuff, made some money, and I didn't even know about it, and you had me writing a cashier's check for $2,500 to bail her out." I was like, "Don't worry about it, don't cry about it. We made a $700 profit out of it, okay?" He was like, No, you made $700 profit. Now she calling me crying and screaming and stuff. What am I supposed to do?" I said, "You're not supposed to do nothing. You're not supposed to do nothing, and you're not gonna be able to do nothing." He's like, "But that's grimy, that's cold." I was like, "Oh, you mad? You mad? You mad over some side chick? I told you we just made $700 profit. So forget about the $2,500." He was like, "What you did wasn't right, though." I said, "Don't worry about what's not right. You stepping out of our marriage is not right. And for you to think that I'm not going to benefit anything out of it, you must be out of your mind, okay? I can't step out of our marriage because I respect my vows very much. Obviously, you don't, and she doesn't respect my matrimonial home. So she got to suffer. She gets to suffer the consequences. She can't come back at me with no court case because everything is documented." He was like, "You know what? You know what? I'm so embarrassed by what you did." I was like, "Well, that's on you. If she's crying, you can go and comfort her, but you won't be able to do nothing because." You know why? I took the power of attorney to your bank and wipe your savings account out and put it in my bank. And then on top of that, I set up an allotment so that when you get paid, a bulk of your paycheck will also go to my savings account, and you'll only be left with the approximate amount that you usually pay the bills with. So you will not be looking out for her at all to put any more and to buy anything to replace those furniture. She agreed to get out of jail by selling her stuff. I assisted her. She being very ungrateful. So that's between you and her, but no money will be going towards anything that she has lost because it's her fault. And all of that setup is going to remain like that for the entire year. You're not going to do nothing. You're my husband. I have the right to do that." He was like, "Oh my goodness. I didn't know you was this crazy." No, I said, "I'm not crazy. What I am is a female who know how to benefit out of her husband's blunders with his side."